Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today, in this video, I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Visual Studio in a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily create a simple desktop application using C# language within our Windows operating system. So this video is going to be a bit long, but I can guarantee you that if you stick with this video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always comment in your comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install Visual Studio, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and to just simply search over here, Visual Studio download. Now remember that we are downloading Visual Studio, not Visual Studio code. So Visual Studio icon is like this, and Visual Studio code is a text editor, so it is a bit different. So if I just simply type Visual Studio code, you can see that its icon is different. So the Visual Studio code is a text editor, but Visual Studio is a complete IDE. Alright, so in this video, I'm going to talk about Visual Studio. In my previous videos, I have already showed you about Visual Studio code. Alright, so now to install Visual Studio, you need to first simply go to this link. So this link I'm going to put right in your description, so you can directly use that link to land over to this official site of Visual Studio. So here if you scroll down, you can see our latest version of Visual Studio is version 2022. Alright, so here you can see we have three options: Community, Professional and Enterprise. So these are paid version, but this is community one, so you can always click on this, you know, download, and it's going to, you know, start downloading our installer. So Visual Studio Setup installer is rightly started downloading, and you can see that our Visual Studio Setup is rightly downloaded. So let's, you know, click on this open file to install it locally on our system. So it will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and let's minimize our browser. So Visual Studio installer, click on continue. So it will start getting all the Visual Studio installer, and you'll be seeing this Visual Studio installer page. So getting things ready, and then you'll be seeing this page. All right, so here I'm going to, you know, recommend you to select this ASP.NET and web development. So that's the first one. And then if you went to Python programming or Node.js, that is JavaScript and all, so then you can select all these. You can also select Azure if you are into Azure cloud and all, but here in this video I'm going to, you know, select only the popular one. So generally whoever is developing any ASP.NET or C#, you know, desktop application, so they only mostly use Visual Studio. All right, so that's why I'm selecting only ASP.NET, the popular one, and I am also going to select this .NET desktop development. So for C#, Visual Basic and all that, they use, you know, WinForm projects and all. So for that I am selecting this .NET desktop application. And if you want to select C++ as well, if you want to develop desktop application using C++. And then the third one that I'm going to select is this Universal Windows Platform Development. So I'm going to select this these three. And then gaming also, if you are into gaming, if you want to develop gaming software, so that also you can develop using our Visual Studio. So you can select all these if you are interested. And I'm going to skip all this, and I'm going to select this data storage and processing. All right, so that will help to establish our connection with our SQL Server. So in my previous videos, I have showed you how to install Microsoft SQL Server. So you can always watch that video. So, you know, you can always connect with this, with that SQL Server using this tool set. So I'm going to select that. And parallelly, if you are into, you know, all this Visual Studio extension development, or, you know, Linux embedded development with C++, all these you can also select. But for now, I'm going to select only the popular one. So I'm going to select this one, and I'm going to click on install, and it's going to start, you know, downloading all the files and going to install it locally on our system. So this thing will take, you know, significant amount of time. You need to have active internet connections also. So it will going to, you know, fetch lot of file, about, you can see 6 GB of file it's going to, you know, fetch from internet, and then it's going to parallelly install it on our system. So it will take, you know, about 15 minutes I would say, and you need to have good amount of space also on your C drive. So nearly 23 to 24 gigabyte of space you need to have at least, so it's going to install there, right? So this will take time. You can grab some coffee or tea. I'll be doing that, and after, you know, this get installed, I'm going to again back to this video. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our Visual Studio Community version 2022 is rightly installed. So you can see all installations are updated. So our community version is totally installed now. We can just simply click on this launch button to launch our Microsoft Visual Studio version 2022. And you can see that our Microsoft Visual Studio is rightly launched, and it is telling to sign in to Visual Studio. You can always, you know, create a new account, or if you already have an existing Microsoft account, you can always use that to sign in. For now, I'm going to skip this, but remember, it is very important to sign in. Alright, so for now, I'm going to, you know, skip this, and I'm going to, you know, here choose the dark theme. If you want to choose any other theme like blue light or blue, you can always choose that. I'll be selecting the dark one. So generally programmers select the dark one, so I'm going to select that, and I'm going to click on start Visual Studio, and it's going to start our Visual Studio, and you can see that our Visual Studio is rightly open. So you can close this Visual Studio installer. So you can choose, you know, create a new project, as I'm going to, you know, show you how to create a simple WinForm project. So I'm going to here select this drop down, and I'm going to select C#. And in all platform, I'm going to select Windows. And here in all project types, I'm going to select desktop application. All right, and immediately you'll be seeing Windows form app. So I'm going to select this Windows form app, and then I'm going to click on next. So here you need to give a project name. So let's give the project name as Hello World, and then I'm going to click on next. So it's going to start creating our project. So our, you know, latest .NET version is .NET version 8.0, so which also has a long-term support. So I'm going to select that and click on create. It's going to start create our project. So you can see that our project is slightly launched, so it is waiting for IntelliSense to finish initializing. So let's wait for some time, and you can see that our project is rightly open along with our form 1. So if you expand this Hello World, you'll be able to see all these files, and you'll be seeing this program.cs. If you click on that, it will open our main method. So you can see we are starting our form 1 from here. So here we are invoking our form 1. So that is our this form, right? So let's go to view and click on this toolbox, and you'll be seeing this toolbox initializing. And once it get initialized, you need to expand this all Windows form, and here let's, you know, drag one button. So I'm going to select this button, and I'm going to drag that on our form 1, and after that, if I just, you know, simply click on this Hello World project, it's going to start building our project, and it's going to launch our project soon. You can see that build is succeeded, so our project going to be launched. And you can see that our project is rightly launched, so which is showing this button 1, right? So we have placed this button 1, right? And that button 1 is properly coming over here, right? So you can close this, and you'll be again back to our Visual Studio, right? So in this way, you can easily install Visual Studio, and you can, you know, start developing desktop application. So you can always comment in our comment sections if you need more videos on our WinForm project. So I'll show you how to create desktop applications. So different types of desktop applications, like how to create a calculator or how to create a student dashboard, all that. And I have also started a Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I'm posting coding related videos. So if you're interested, you can always subscribe Geeky Syntax channel. So that will really motivate me to make more such videos. And I have also started Geeky Script vlogging channel. So if you're interested, you can also subscribe this channel as well. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.